What's up, iCommerce fans? Earlier this year, Industry 9 dropped two new hubs, the Hydra at the high end, which has like a super tight engagement, and the 101s, which drops down just a little bit below where the Torch series was, but comes in at a much lower price point. Then, a couple months later, they announced that they'd be building those 101s into complete wheel sets, which is what you see here, for just $750 with Industry 9 rims. With that comes plenty of options. You've got trail or enduro rim builds, 29er or 27.5, but you're limited to black. So you can only get in black, built with black Supreme spokes and black rims. But you're not giving up much else. We're going to show you the insides in just a second, but basically you've got your choice of two different boost sizes and super boost in the rear. The front, you do only get 15 by 110 boost. You can choose between center lock and six bolt and enduro and trail rim widths. Now, the question is, if you're paying that much less, where do they cut corners, if at all, and how do these things ride?
First things first, because I know what you i9 fans are wondering. Yes, you still get that infamous Industry 9 coasting noise carried over from Torch. Our trails are a mix of ups and downs with fast corners that are rarely bermed. So we're putting a lot of lateral load on the wheels when ripping around a corner and wiggling between trees at speed. Sure, a lot of other factors come into play here, like tires and frame and fork stiffness, but for their part, the 101 trail wheels always felt like they were tracking true. Small jumps and drops are no problem, even when they land straight into a high-speed turn or repetitive root section. Tubeless setup was easy, and the rims measured as claimed, giving our tires plenty of volume and grip. Engagement is plenty quick for climbs, whether you're grinding in a low gear or having to all of a sudden shift under power. The 101 hubs don't get polished like the Hydra hubs do, and you can see the difference here. Inside, the hubs have a machine drive ring and six pawls, offering 90 points of engagement with 4.5 degrees of rotation. Three pawls are engaged at any point, and there's a new rubber seal around the outside. Just note that if you do swap free hub bodies, you'll have to pop that seal off, replace the body, and then pop it back into place.
So is it worth it? $750 for an Industry 9 wheel set? Yeah, absolutely. There's really nothing about these that I miss compared to the Torch wheel sets I've been riding before, except for the colors and, you know, maybe that like tightly machined look to the hub shells. Other than that, if you don't mind only having the option of black, there's really nothing I think anybody's going to complain about these. The weights are reasonable, especially for the price. You've got great proven internals from a company with a great reputation, hand built here in Asheville, North Carolina. And you know, the rims have been solid. I've had no problems, no dings from even like hitting a few things with low air pressure. There's really nothing that indicates this is a, you know, kind of like budget wheel set, if you will, if you could call $750 a budget wheel set. I'm loving these things. So if you don't mind not having the choice of colors, then I'd say go for it.
For a complete technical explanation of how these are improved and different from the Torch and Hydra hubs, click the link in the description for the full review on BikeRumor.com.